So let's look at what the code for this would look like with a quick walkthrough of some of the pieces. You'll need to do something similar later using the documentation as a guide. Imagine we need to transmit the number of steps detected on an Android Wear device to a paired-up phone. Let's open up the mainactivity.java file contained in the wearable project we just created. So it's in the Wear directory, Java, mainactivity. The data API is provided by Google Play Services, so we need to first create a connection to this API. Note that this does not connect to the wearable, it just allows your app to make Google Play Services API calls. So after we put this code in, we need to hit Alt Enter a few times to add the necessary packages. We also need to create a variable to store the connection in. And we also need to implement two classes that are part of Google API Client for handling connection success and failure. So let's provide the implementation for those methods here. We don't have any code to put in them, so let's just leave them blank for now. Now let's look at the code used to create a data item. Let's create a method sendStepCount that does this for us. We firstly create a putDataMap request, and we need to specify a path for it. The path shown here is used to reference this object and make it unique compared to all the other ones that we can create. Next, we use put methods to add an integer and long key value pair. We then use putDataItem to submit the object, and then we need to check for errors with a callback defined underneath. Error handling is very interesting because it just indicates that the object was successfully stored locally. It does not tell you if the object was received by a remote device yet. It is totally okay for the remote device to not even be connected. When the device connects, the data item will be synchronized later on, so you'll never receive feedback that the remote device has received it. If you need this kind of feedback, you'll need to code up some kind of feedback mechanism yourself. Another analogy for this is that a package delivery company giving you an acknowledgement that the package has been collected. It has not been delivered to the recipient yet and might take some time to get there. One important point is that data items are promised to never be lost and will eventually arrive once the other device is paired up. Let's now look at the receiving code on the phone. So let's expand the project viewer and work in the mobile project now. On the receiver side, it's quite easy to find when new data items arrive. You simply create a service for this. So let's go to File, New, and Service. Create it with all the defaults and then hit Enter. The first thing we need to do is make sure it inherits from wearable listener service and add dependencies. You can also remove the entire implementation because we're going to replace it. You then override the onDataChange method, which has passed an array of data events that have occurred. For each data event object, you can retrieve the data map and then extract out the path and values for each key from before. You can see here that we're looking for a change. We're then extracting out the path. We're testing if the path equals a certain string, and then we pull out the integer and long value to do whatever we want with it. The final step is to adjust the Android manifest XML on the receiving side to make sure our listener service handles the bind listener intent. Google Play Services will then handle all the necessary behind-the-scenes work to get the data items to your listener. You don't need to start this service yourself. So let's expand the project and open up the Android manifest XML file. The final step is to adjust the Android manifest.xml on the receiving side to make sure our listener service handles the bind listener intent. Google Play Services will then handle all the necessary behind-the-scenes work to get the data items to your listener. You don't need to worry about starting this service yourself. Oh, and one more thing. Let's go back to the sending code and talk about large items. Data items are typically limited to about 100 kilobytes, so make sure you do not exceed this size. However, if you need to send something like an image, it's possible using the asset class. You convert your bitmap into a PNG byte stream and then store it into a data item using putAsset. This deals with sending the image in a way that works around the 100 kilobyte limit. So that's it for sending data items. The fundamentals are really easy, and most of the hard work like handling the connections and sending the data is all taken care of for you. So you can focus on the important parts of your app instead.